me and Charlo.
But when did you know boxing was for you? Like, I mean, the amateurs, obviously. But at what point you know, like, this is it?
When I knew I could crack and keep up with the big dogs.
At age 11, 10, 12?
Yeah, I was cracking at 14, 15. I think I was made for me.
That's the first time you sparred an adult and you dropped them or knocked them out or something?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, you heard through the grapevine. But yeah. I was through crack back in the days. And then I turned pro at 17, just turned 17. I was already going pro. So I was already working on my pro debut.
While you're still in high school?
Yeah, I was still in high school. December 7th, I took my pro debut. Yep. For sure. I had Shelly Pink was my manager.
Golden Boy
Promotion gave me a big check. And Al Heyman was like, I'm going to come get you, nigga. You mine. And I knew exactly when I got with Al Heyman. That was promised.
You're made. Yeah.
I used to be signed with Josh Dubin. You know who that is? Josh Dubin was the manager of Lennox Lewis.
Yeah, I know him. They're still friends. They still hang out.
Canadian
guy.
Josh Dubin, a real cool dude. Yeah, he from New York up there. Yeah. Josh Dubin, he held me through a little bit.
With the glasses, I know.
Yeah. He made me pay a little bit of money to get out my contract, but I mean, that's the name of the game. It's a business. Tell Dubin, come get my money back, Dubin. I'm just your friend.
That's cool. But listen, you got to meet the best of the best, the biggest name, the people, like working with Lennox, working with Tyson, because Shelly worked with everybody.
Yeah.
You know what I always call him? Captain Stubin.
Captain Stubin.
He looked like Captain Stubin from the Love Boat.
Yeah, Shelly looked like that motherfucking cartoon character from The Simpsons, that motherfucking boss man.
I'm Mr. Burns.
Yeah,
he's doing his thing.
Yeah, but Shelly's still doing his thing. Yeah. He had to give up boxing whenever the Klitschko's. He had got into some other legal stuff, and then he had to let all his boxers go.
Yeah.
I was one of them.
And he came back.
Yeah, but he had to let them all go, and he only kept his heavyweights, which was Deontay Wilder at the time. And we think he still manages Deontay Wilder.
Yeah, no, they're
shout out to Wilder, nigga. Shout out to Wilder. Yeah. Ronnie got a song out. Yeah. In love, baby. Wilder getting that big bag.
He's a good dude. Wilder's a good person. Like, genuinely a nice guy.
You know the LBC, whatever community gonna come attack me because I'm fucking with you, Ellie. But it's all cool. I don't give a fuck. Tell them I love them too. One love, baby.
We love everybody.
Yeah,
no hate. Ellie Sekback reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.